Good morning, class. Now, continuing with the same chapter, shapes and designs. Today, we will study the properties of square. If you see, this is a square. Okay? In the previous video, I have told you that this is the triangle, this is rectangle, this is a square, this is parallelogram, rhombus, pentagon, hexagon, circle, curved line and straight line. So, today, we will study the properties of square. Okay? If we see this. This is a square. Now, if we see its property, so first one is a square has four sides, that is AB, BC, CD and DA. If we count the number of sides in a square, there are four. Now, see AB, BC, CD and DA. These are the four sides in a square. It has four vertex, that is A, B, C, D. Now, vertex, I have already told that. Vertex is a corner. This is a vertex. And vertex is also called as corner. So how many vertex are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. And if we call them by the name, then it will be A, B, C and D. That means a square has 4 sides and it has 4 vertex. Now if you see the third one, all the sides of a square are equal. That is AB equals to BC, equals to CD, equals to DA. That means if we see a square and we see the sides, so all the sides are of equal length. That means if AB is of 5 cm, so BC will be also of 5 cm, CD will be also of 5 cm and DA will be also of 5 cm. That means all the sides of the square are equal. That means length of AB is equals to length of BC, is equals to length of CD, is equals to length of DA. Understood this? Now see the fourth one. It has two diagonals, AC and BD. Now in the previous video, I have told you what the diagonals are. When we join the opposite vertex, like B and D are opposite to each other, A and C are opposite to each other. So when we join the opposite vertex, so we get the diagonal. See? This BD line is a diagonal and this AC line is a diagonal. So in a square, there are how many diagonals? There are two diagonals in a square. That is AC and BD. See, this is AC and this is BD. Now we will study the properties of circle. Can you see the figure? This is a circle. Now if we try to find the number of side, so can you count the number of side in a circle? No. We cannot count the number of sides in a circle. So the first point is that it has no side. Why? Because we cannot count the number of sides in a circle. And if we see this O, so what is O? O is the center of the circle. If we find the center of the circle, so this O will be the center of this circle. So we have written here, O is the center of the circle. So this is the property of a circle and this is the property of a square. Understood everyone? Okay, thank you.